Katie Couric is in. She comes
Katie
in.
Katie in the house.
I mean, you talk about, I thought we had some energy. She comes roaming in here with a parade of people, and it's so great to see you.
So nice to be here, and I love your whole posse,
if you ever want someone to fill in for me, like if you guys really are sick of me, she would be the greatest to host the show with you.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know all those buttons.
No, you don't have to. Yeah.
You wouldn't need to figure any of that out. We would
Tubbs,
figure
our
that
engineer,
out.
Will help you out. Mm-hmm. He's over there. Cubs and I are the only men left on this show.
I know. It's, you know, who runs the world? Girls.
Well, yes.
I think
women are actually kind of taking over, and isn't it fantastic?
Well, mm-hmm. For me, it's the greatest life lesson ever because I get Rippa every day and then for an hour, and then I get the...
That sounds like you get ripped every day.
Well, I do. I learn so much. I'm in awe of the things that I learn, and it's all, like, I don't even have to sign up for the therapy to pay for because they give me the therapy for free and they pay us. It's all a good thing.
And I love that. I love that, Kelly Rippa. Tell her I said hi.
I will. So Katie is here. I mean, I've just been introduced to her whole board of directors. you told me your company. So what are you? You're doing a lot of things we'll talk about. But how would you describe what you're doing now in terms of all of your different tentacles?
Well, I'm trying to be the female Ryan Seacrest.
I'm trying to be either the male or female Ryan Seacrest. Doesn't matter.
So I basically, my husband and I, John, you've met John,
I know John
Molnar, started a company about a year and a half ago because, you know, I'd pretty much done everything in the TV news business.
Yeah.
And I decided I wanted to really try to be an entrepreneur for the first time, assemble a group of great people, pay it forward, help young journalists who are interested in writing and reporting and doing documentaries and basically do all kinds of media. So I have a newsletter called Wake Up Call. Uh-huh. We have a team that does that. I've just relaunched my podcast. I'm doing a lot of collaborations. This probably would interest you, Ryan. I don't know if you're doing this as well, but I noticed a while ago, and it's really come to fruition, that companies want to be really appreciated for their values and the ethos in that company.
In
that
what they stand for.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. They want to stand for more than just the bottom line.
Mm-hmm.
And they want to really epitomize purpose over profit, or at least emphasize it somewhat. Mm-hmm. So I started working with great companies like Procter & Gamble, which really has been
small
on the
little,
forefront.
Small little boutique group.
It's just
huge.
A small little company. Ally Financial, Rally Health, Sleep Number. Because they all want to put content out in the world. They want to be storytellers. So I'm editorially independent, but I focus on things like gender equality. I did a series called Getting There, where I profiled very successful women and sort of how they accomplish their goals. I'm doing two documentaries right now, one on plastic waste and one on loneliness.
There's two things I'm thinking about. One, I mean, like all of those days and mornings waking up early, I would think to myself, you'd ride off into the sunset and enjoy sleeping in, but no. You are asking for more.
You know what? I like to work. I like feeling productive.
You like the pace.
I also, I mean, I'm so insatiably curious about everything that's happening. And we've never gone through a more transformational time, I think, in our lives, Ryan, in terms of how technology is shifting almost every arena. And there's so much happening. And I think I'm good at translating trends and issues and making them understandable for people. And that's really why I got into journalism in the first place.
So we're not journalists, but we're going to ask you some questions about some of the things that maybe you could pursue in your podcast, because we've been talking about them here. And I think that, like you mentioned, plastic. Like I was told we talked to an ichthyologist, the fish scientist, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking about all the plastic that's in fish and how that plastic stays in us. And, you know, I'm told to eat fish, but then all of a sudden there's plastic in the fish. And so now what do I eat?
Right. And now there are plastic particles in the air. There's so much plastic waste. And I'm so interested in connecting the dots for people. How did we get here? And I do think that it's reached critical mass, that people care about it. My husband bought a reusable straw. I just bought a cup at Starbucks that I can reuse every time I go in and get coffee, because it's actually, you feel ashamed when you're using plastic these days.
You do. Yeah. And we should keep touting that, actually.
Yes,
in a way.
Yes. All right. I think shame is such a powerful motivator.
Yes, we wake up in a pool of shame every day. That's
no,
what we do.
Serious.
This show
it
is
really
full of shame. We're ashamed of what we do.
It changes behavior,
it
though.
Does. It shame them out. All right, let's come back in a second. We'll talk more with Katie Couric after this. Katie Couric is here. Her podcast is called Next Question with Katie Couric. It's available next Thursday on the iHeartRadio app, which is our home app, our headquarters, or wherever you listen to podcasts.
We did a special preview episode that we dropped, as they say.
I heard. So the premise, though, of the podcast, are there any boundaries or can you cover anything?
I can cover anything.
All right. We have some things that we're curious about.
Okay.
I think maybe you could shed some light on. One, my mother and scams. So my mother, there's so many tech scams going on right now. Right? My mother calls me today. She's all up in arms. She's like, the IT people are calling me. I said, what do you mean the IT people? She said, the IT people are calling her because someone hacked her email and said, hey, can you do me a favor to all of her contacts, some of my friends, many of my friends. And then when people responded, the hacker through her own email said, yeah, could you go buy me some iTunes gift cards? And they were trying to get credit card information and everything like this. Right. So
yeah,
we talked about it on the air. Turns out Tanya's mom had the same sophisticated hack happen to her mom.
When? Recently?
Mine was within the last month.
Oh,
so recently.
That's really, so obviously it's kind of this new scam targeting people of a certain age.
I'm wondering, is it targeting a certain age or targeting soft passwords? I don't know, but that's one. The
okay.
other one.
That'll be a next question.
So
what the hell's going on with the IT person?
With the IT people. So the other scam that we have uncovered that's happening a lot, we think, based on our friends and people calling in. This happened to my friend. She called to change her ticket at a major carrier airline, called the 800 number.
Yeah.
Her call was intercepted by a sophisticated scam who said they repped the airline. They put her on hold with the same hold music as the airline has. They went and they asked for a credit card number. They said, hold, please. They came back and they said, that's going to cost you $500 a head to change your ticket. Not true. What we learned happened after two times is that when she was on hold, the scammer would call the airline, adjust the ticket with the credit card number for $20 or whatever, and then go back to us and say it's going to be $1,000, and it shows up on your credit card as the airline.
Oh, my God.
And this now happened
that
to—
That is so sophisticated,
two or three
isn't
characters.
It?
Mm-hmm. So there's like, I think there's something to the sophistication of interception in these scams that's scaring me.
Right, and your mom's.
And how do you know? How do you authenticate?
Yeah, well, you know, I even get texts— messages from banks and I think, oh no, I've overdrawn my, you know, or whatever. My credit card is on the fritz, and my husband always says, don't hit that link. But you kind of don't know because they look so realistic.
Right.
But that would be a good podcast, Ryan.
But it's so sophisticated these days. But when they're intercepting your incoming call, that scares me.
Right. Yeah,
and
I
don't even know how do you authenticate something? Like, call me back, but then it could be the person intercepted?
Yeah, because essentially you're calling the correct number, but they're intercepting.
Right.
So
right.
I've gotten to the place now when I get any email, I ignore it, but then I ignore real emails now.
I know. I know what you mean, though. I think it's better to ignore it than to
dive into a problem.
You know, sucked into the vortex of a scam.
All right, so that's one. And the other one, just to pitch for your podcast, which you can hear on iHeartRadio.
He's producing your podcast now.
I'm just giving you ideas. I don't have the army to produce them. But the other one that we're reading about a lot, and I care about what I eat and what I put into my body for longevity.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm thinking about the future of the planet. I'm thinking about all these things. I generally like to eat plants and fish. Like, that's my thing anyway, more plants anyway. But we were reading that in our lifetime, we may be seeing more and more bugs on menus for protein and longevity and health value because it will help save the planet. So we asked the question, if you could help save the planet and get all the nutrition you need, would you order the grasshoppers and the earthworms and all that stuff?
Or crickets, or whatever they serve.
But I'm wondering, will we see that as a solution for what's happening on the planet? And should we invest in those companies now?
Very interesting. I like that. But I also, you know, I'm very interested in nutrition. I did a documentary called Fed Up.
Yes, I remember you talked about
a few years ago about sugar and how much hidden sugar there is in food. But I think
love
not
that
only
documentary.
Is not, oh, you should watch it. I have to say it's really interesting and good. And the young man in it lost so much weight. Now he's going to medical school, Brady.
Amazing.
And it's so exciting. But I also would like to figure out about it and really help people understand how meat consumption contributes to global warming.
It's so fun to have a podcast because you can do anything.
Tell people to sign up for my newsletter, Wake Up Call, by going to katiecouric.com.
There you go, katiecouric.com.
I love talking to you, Ryan. We could do this all day.
Well, we have 4 hours a day to fill every day of the week. So anytime. If you have a hot new topic, call us, all right?
Bye, Katie.
I will.